The silence that prevailed in the valley after the first round of 5 civilian killings last week was shattered on the weekend as Kashmir witnessed cold-blooded murders of 4 more unarmed known locals within a span of 24 hours. On Saturday evening, the ultras first killed the known local Golgappa seller Arbind Kumar Sah from Bihar at Hawal in Srinagar's old city within an hour, and another known local carpenter Sagheer Ahmed from Uttar Pradesh was shot dead in South Kashmir's Pulwama district. On Sunday evening, militants once again appeared at Wanpoh in South Kashmir's Kulgam district and shot at 3 known local laborers. 2 of them, Raja Rishi Dev and Jogindar Rishi Dev, died on the spot, while the other one, Chun Chun Reshi, sustained injuries. The victims, all small-time laborers, were residents of Bihar. Of the 11 civilians killed in the recent attacks, 5 were from other states. Among the victims were Makhan Lal Bintru, a prominent member of the Kashmiri Pandit community and owner of a pharmacy in Srinagar; Mohammed Shafi Lone, a taxi driver; teachers Deepak Chand and Supinda Kaur, and street vendor Virendra Paswan. During the past 1 week, security forces have intensified counter-insurgency operations. According to the police, 13 militants have been killed in 9 encounters after the civilian killings. The Inspector General of Police Kashmir has stated that 3 out of the 5 militants involved in the civilian killings in Srinagar have been eliminated. Many people are of the opinion that attacks on known local laborers and members of minority communities are an attempt to push them out of Kashmir. Ultras are choosing soft targets as they are aware of the fact that they won't face any resistance from the unarmed victims whom they are out to kill. The militants are aware that mounting an attack on security forces means getting killed. They are killing civilians to remain in the news and to ensure that fear of gun returns to the valley. The cold-blooded murders of innocent civilians have sent shockwaves across Kashmir. Besides, known locals, natives are also living under constant fear and threat. The guns that are targeting known locals and members of the minority communities today can turn towards the majority community tomorrow. Natives can be labeled as mukbirs and then killers. It won't be an exaggeration to mention that after August 5, 2019, when the center announced its decision to abrogate J&K special status and divided it into 2 union territories, more than 90% people in Jammu and Kashmir welcomed the complete merger of the erstwhile princely state into the Union of India completely. J&K didn't react to the abrogation of the special status. There were no street protests or stone pelting incidents, and transition of the erstwhile state into a union territory turned out to be a smooth affair. The people of Kashmir, endorsing the agenda of peace, development and prosperity, has not gone down well with the militant bosses sitting across the line of control. They seem unhappy with the Kashmiris. By getting known locals killed by sponsored ultras, militant handlers are projecting Kashmiris as terrorists who won't be welcomed in any part of India if the violence against the known locals continues. They are trying to kill 2 birds with 1 arrow by forcing an exodus of known locals from Kashmir. They want to keep the threat perception alive. And secondly, they are trying to project Kashmiris as hate mongers and killers. The killings have left Kashmiri leaders speechless. They seem worried and are condemning these acts of senseless violence vociferously. National Conference President and former J&K Chief Minister Farooq Abdullah, while reacting to these murders, said that Kashmiris were not involved in these acts. These attacks are being carried out under a conspiracy to defame Kashmiris. These incidents are an attempt to disturb the peaceful atmosphere in J&K, he said. It's not only Farooq Abdullah who has realized that a conspiracy has been hatched to label every Kashmiri as a terrorist, but many other people have also realized it. They are aware of the fact that Pakistan is out to punish them for dumping the agenda of separatists and endorsing the idea of inclusive India. They are aware that the guns can turn towards the natives who are not interested in violence and want to live a peaceful life. The situation in Kashmir has turned volatile and the sense of insecurity has crept into every section of the society. The police and the security forces are trying their best to keep the militants at bay, but the lone wolf attacks and ultras gunning down unarmed people have emerged as major challenges. IGP Kashmir Vijay Kumar has made it explicitly clear that providing security to all soft targets is not possible. Time and again I'm saying that there is no lapse on the security front. Soft targets were attacked who were not provided security by us. It is not possible to provide security to every soft target. We have identified the militants behind the civilian killings, he told reporters after 2 Lashkar-e-Taiba militants, Umar Khandi and Muhammad Sultan, were killed in an encounter encounter with the security forces in the Pampore area on Saturday afternoon. After the Pampore encounter, ultras have killed 4 known locals in 3 attacks, one in Srinagar city and 3 others in South Kashmir's Pulwama and Kulgam districts. A report carried out by a news channel on Sunday morning, a day after the killing of known local vendor Arbind Kumar Sah in Srinagar's old city, revealed that fear has gripped the known locals as they didn't set up their carts in Hawal area where Sah was killed. A few known local vendors who spoke to the reporter told him that they want to go back home as soon as possible. Life is more important than income, they said. The ultras to an extent have succeeded in creating fear among the outsiders as many of them are willing to leave the valley. It appears that the damage has been done. The militants are once again out to destroy Kashmir and push it back into oblivion so that the people remain deprived of peace, prosperity and development. The militants are out to punish Kashmiris collectively for not supporting them and their ideology. The valley is once again witnessing dangerous times. News Desk, Kaumudy Global.